Hi everyone, today I'm talking about ACS diagram. The ACS diagram, that means it's an automatic transfer circuit. In my video today, I have the two part. The first one is I explain to you how the it work, how the the diagram is working. And the second one, I will show to you with my ATS sample. Now, my friends, please follow me. It's the ATS diagram. That means it's we have the law over here. Get true power. Get from the first one. Get from the electricity, and all the power sound we get from the generator over there. This circuit is mean is when the electricity is off, the generator is on. It make the power supply to the load over here. And when the electric come back again, it will go to turn off the generator over here by the timer number 3 over here. And for the starting the generator here, starting engine here, the power is get from the battery. We have the two way. The first one is automatic. The second way is the manual. It's a start by hand. Okay. In my board is on the left hand side here. We have the electricity. We have the MCCB. Have the fuse. Relay number 1, the line here, the line is that mean when the line is on, that mean the we have the electricity, we have the power. Here is the contactor 1 is for the electricity. Output of the contactor 1 for the electricity here connect to the load. And this system here for charge battery and for the starter engine over here, we have the power supply for this system here through source. The one get from the electricity by terminal normally open of the relay number 1 here, and on all the power source get from the generator here. It by the relay number 2 here at the terminal, normally open up the relay number 2 here. It supply power to the transformer. Transformer convert the AC to the DC and supply power to the charge control. Between the transformer and the charge control, I make the fuse. For the safety for the charge control and battery, if the transformer is it convert the power, it not the same voltage, maybe it destroys the charge control and battery. That's why I make the fuse between transformer and the charge control like that. The charge control here, it control the power from the battery over here. When the battery is low level, the charge control will recharge for the battery, keep battery it full. When battery is full, the charge control will open the circuit, down charge the power to the battery again, it's normal. And this side here, this one is the contactor get the power from the generator, that's why I wrote it. Generator here, that means it's a contactor over here. Contactor number 2 here get power from the generator over there. And this one is the relay number 2. This one is line when the generator working, it make the power go to the MCCB, go to the fuse and supply to the line. When the line is on, we know this side have the power. and the output of the contactor generator here, T1, T2, T3 here, the output of the generator here, contactor here, T1, 2, 3 here, will supply power to the load here, and we connect the T1, T2, T3 of the output from the output of the generator contactor together with the output of the contactor of the electricity power and connect to the load. I mean the output of the contactor generator here connect with the output of the electricity contactor and together it's we connect to the load to together. And the sign here, this system here, from here down there, it's the I have the this one, the switch, the left hand side for the auto, the right hand side for the manual. If I do with the I turn switch here to the left hand side here, it that mean it the auto. When the electricity here is off, the power, the positive from the battery here go over there, go to that line, go to that side and supply power for timer 1. I set time for timer 1, it's 1 minute. After 1 minute, terminal 8 and 6 here, it will close and supply power for timer number 2. Timer number 2 here, I set time for this one, it's the 10 seconds. First go to start the engine over here. After 10 seconds, terminal 8 and 5 of the timer number 2 here, it will open. That's why over here don't have the power. You don't worry, it will the start the engine again. And after 10 seconds, that terminal 8 and 5 open and the power will go to the 8 and 6 and it will flow and supply to the line here. The out, the on other side of the line connect to the both the negative by the battery over there. If the first time start for the automatic, the engine is on, the power go to the MCCB generator, make the power. The power go to MCCB to the fuse and supply to the relay number 2 here. And when relay working, all terminal normally open, now it close, and all terminal normally close, now it's open. That's why when the relay number 2 here working, this terminal and this terminal it will open. That's why the system for starter engine here don't have the power. It's very safety. You don't worry, it will start engine again. Don't worry, because this terminal and that terminal it open, that side don't have the power. And the line here is on, that means generator have the power and will supply to the terminal. Normally open of the relay number 2 here, it will close, make the coil of the contactor generator here, it close, and it supply connect the L1, L2, L3, connect power to T1, T2, T3, and supply power to the load over here. That is the automatic. If you want to do to start the engine here by hand, you turn switch here to the right hand side to the manual. The power get from the battery here, positive here to this line, and go to is a relay 1, relay 2 to the start. The start here you don't need to have the memory over here. Just the only start like that, the single like that. and you put in the stack the power supply to the relay number 2 relay number 3 and terminal normally open of the relay number 3 here it will close supply power to start the engine and this terminal it will open that side don't have the power too and when you start you put your hand down like that it's the supply power to the relay number 3 and terminal normally open of the relay number 3 here it close and supply power to start the engine. When the engine is on, generator is working, it supply power the same way with the automatic. And when the generator here working, all terminal of the relay number 2 here normally close, now it open this one and that one open. This side don't have the power too. And during the generator working when the electric go back again this relay here relay number 1 here have the power it made the terminal open here it now close and supply power L1 L2 L3 T1 and T3 supply to the close over there while the electricity and generator have the power at the same time the supply power to the low at the same time what happened in here no problem it's the relay number 1 here normally open now it close supply power for the timer number 3 over there and I set time for the timer number 3 here it the 5 minutes after 5 minutes terminal 8 and 6 here it will close and power supply to the part go to turn off the engine go to turn off the generator here go to turn off the generator that why when the when we have the power saw from the generator and we have the power from the electricity at the low of supply to the low here no problem and after 5 minutes for the close here it's the power is comfortable after 5 minutes that the timer here it will close and go to turn off the engine and in my diagram it very very perfectly because when electricity off and on like that the timer 1 here it don't start engine start when the electricity off this one start when electricity on this one off like it's the it made the starter engine here it shock that why it I connect the timer 1 here I set up for this one it the 1 minute when electricity go when electricity it off if 30 second the timer here it cannot supply power to the timer 2 start engine if electricity it off over minute the over minute the timer 1 here it close and supply power for timer 2 and start the engine and when the electricity we have the low here we have the electricity and we have the power go to, get from the generator here after 5 minutes the timer 3 here get power from the relay number 1 here go to the turn off the engine by the timer 3 here I check for that it 5 minutes that why it working comfortable now my friends when you connect the new generator and the electricity to the load you connect already like that. Don't start. No, you should be test the engine first. You turn up. You disconnect the MCCB here. First thing is a you test for the automatic first. You turn the switch here to the this side automatic to the left hand side here. Then you disconnect the MCCB here. The power will supply to the this side, this way, and supply to the timer 1, timer 2, and start engine. And when the engine working, the generator working, this terminal and this terminal, it will open. You turn switch to the manual, you start by hand here. It doesn't work because this terminal and that terminal is open. And now it working, right? Now you test the manual. When you test the manual, you turn the circuit here to the manual and you disconnect the MCCB. The power get from the battery supply over there and supply to the R1, R2 normally close here and to the start, to the this side. You hand, you put the start, the power, this terminal, it will connect and supply power to the relay number 3. And normally of the relay number 3 here, this terminal, it will close and supply power to start the engine over here. When you do like that, the generator is on, and the same with the automatic. This terminal and that terminal, it will open. You start again, don't have the power. This stump here don't have the power. It's very safety for starter. And when you test the automatic and the manual, it working good. Now it's you can connect to you can close the MCCB, it close. You close like that. And you turn the switch here to the auto. Now right now your close here, it get the power from the electricity here. The generator, it doesn't work because it's the electricity, it the main power, not the generator. The generator is the second power. That's why the main power working first. However, when electric come back again, the generator it will up and the your flow here it get the power from the electricity. That's my friend, is the first part, it done. Now I show to you it the second part. My friends, this contactor here get power from the electricity. This contactor here is the get power from the generator over there. The first is relay here, it here. The second at the middle here, relay here. This here, the relay number 2 here. And the relay number 3 here, it here. The first timer, the timer 1 here. The second timer is the timer number 2 here. In my sample, I don't have the timer number 3 because I have not enough the timer. And in my sample, I don't have the generator 2. That's why generator and the timer number 3, I use this circuit. And the middle here, circuit at the middle here, it here. And start by hand here, it here. Now I test for start auto and for start the manual first. After that, I will use the electricity, how does it work. The first, I turn the power on. And it's I turn circuit here to the auto. You see, when I turn the circuit to the auto, you see the line here. You see the red line here. I set time for the timer 1 here. It's 1 minute. After 1 minute, this terminal it will close and supply power to the timer 2 here. Timer 2. Yes, you see the line here, the red line here. It on. It that mean it start the engine. And when the engine is on, the generator is working. The line here, you see the line here, it on. You see. That mean the generator is on. It working. Now the generator is working. It will supply power to the contactor of the generator over here. I use this circuit for the generator over there. You see like that, and the line here, that mean for the glow. You see the line, it on. You see, and when the relay number 2 here, it on, it working. The contactor generator here, it working. This terminal and that terminal, it open. That's why that side don't have the power. I use start by hand here. Let's see. You see, it doesn't work. And the timer 1 here, and timer 2 here, timer 1, timer 2 here, you see, no more power in there. Don't have the power. And it's now it's I will start by hand. I will start by hand. Look how does it work. I will turn circuit to the manual. When I turn the circuit to the manual, the power not supply to the timer, because the timer for the automatic by hand like this one. When I put in the start here, the power supply to the relay number 3 here, and the engine is on. The engine is on, that means the line here is on, and the relay number 3 here working here, it will on. You see, you will see the line. You see, the red line, the relay number 3 here, it on. And the generator here, it on. And it will supply power to the generator contactor over there. You see, it on. And when it's a, when the contactor generator here working, that means relay 2 here working. I start by hand. I put the start. You see here? You see, it doesn't work. The relay number 3 here don't have the power because this terminal and that terminal is open. Okay, now for the outlet, for the auto and for the manual, it working good, right? Now I turn back again. Right now I turn to the switch to the automatic. I turn switch to the automatic. The power will supply for the first timer I said for 1 minute. But the glow here get the power from the electricity. It's the electricity is the main power. That's why you see here. For example, now generator is working, right? It's the light here on, but electricity go back again. It on again. You see, the generator here is off. You see, generator is off, the light here is off. And the light here is on, the glow here, that means the light here, that means the low here. And this conductor here, electricity here is working, and it's when the electricity working like that, the low here, the light, that means the low here, electricity conductor here is working. When the electricity is off, I turn off. You see, the electricity it off, the light, the low here, it off. The power go to the supply to the timer 1 here. After 1 minute, the power will supply to the timer number 2. You see, to the timer number 2, the red light here is on. And the light here is on. That means the generator it working. And the generator working, conductor of the generator here is working, the light here is on, the glow here is on. In that time, when the conductor of the generator here working, you start by hand again, it doesn't work, you see. Or you change the switch here to the auto or manual, don't have the power, you see, don't have the power, don't have the power, and you start by hand here, don't have the power, because this terminal it open. And for example, when electric while the generator is working, the conductor of the generator here, it working, the low here have the power. When the electricity go back again, the generator, conductor of the generator is off, generator is off quickly. But because I don't have the timer number 3 here, if I have the timer number 3 here, I set time for the 5 minutes. That means it's in the after 5 minutes, generator here is off. That I mean after 5 minutes, if I have the timer number 3 here, when the electricity on back again, after 5 minutes, the conductor here it off and generator it off. But I don't have the timer number 3 that. That why when the electric, I turn the electric on back again, quickly generator is stopped. The conductor of the generator here, it off, you see. See? Quickly, when the electricity is on, the generator is off, the conductor of the generator off, the generator is off. And when the electricity working, you start by hand, or you change the switch to the manual or the auto, it doesn't working. You see that by hand here, don't have the power by the switch to the auto and manual, don't have the power, you see. And generator here back and forth, it don't have the power too, because the electricity is the main power. During the electric working, electricity here it working, the terminal relay one here. Here it will open, that why over there the system for the starter engine here don't have the power. That very safety. Now it's I turn up the power. My friends, it's that my video right now at the end. And see you next video. It's I will connect with the truck only through generator without the electricity. That's a hub you for the boss, the ship, or the some space don't have, cannot connect with the power from the by the electricity. That's why they took you the generator, but in the boss, in the ship, or the in the on other space where don't have the electricity, we use the generator. But generator it cannot 24 hour for a day and 7 days per week. Cannot do that. That's why it's I will make the circuit for the two generator. One generator it working at the around it 4 hours, and on other generator it will working after 4 hours, and the first generator it will off, and after 4 hours the first generator is on and second generator is off. Like that, it back and forth, on and off after working after 4 hours. Next time I will connect with my diagram for the two generator, and after that I have the one more video have the two generator working with the one electricity. Thank you for your watching today. Thank you, my friend. If you have your good idea, please leave your message or comment after my video. Thank you.